Hopefully you caught our last video, which gave a brief overview of pneumococcal disease. And today I want to give some information about how we can prevent pneumococcal from occurring in the first place through vaccination. Now, as a reminder, pneumococcal disease is caused by a bacterial infection, and there are more than 90 different strains of this bacteria that can lead to it. However, there are two main groups of vaccines that can help prevent pneumococcal disease from occurring, and they both focus on similar technologies. That is inactivated or dead forms of vaccines, but they don't use the entire bacteria or pathogen. Instead, they focus on one small part, and that's known as polysaccharides. And you can think of polysaccharides like carbohydrates or sugars, and these are found on the outside of bacteria that help it with its mobility. So what researchers did was they isolated out what those different polysaccharides are in these different strains of bacteria, and then they can use that as a vaccine to allow our immune system to recognize those different polysaccharides, create an immune response against it, and then be more prepared to fight off in case we come in contact with that bacteria in the future. Now, the two main groups that are able to have this vaccine first are for individuals who are less than 2 years of age, and that uses conjugated vaccines, meaning that that polysaccharide has now been attached to a protein. And the protein is really important because it helps bring that polysaccharide directly to immune cells, which helps create a more robust and lasting memory of the immune response. And this is good for 13 different strains of bacteria that lead to pneumococcal disease. The second group of vaccines are primarily for individuals who are over the age of 65, and that just uses that isolated form of the polysaccharide. And this usually has a range of about 5 to 10 years of protection. However, it's protective against 23 different strains of bacteria that can lead to pneumococcal disease.